So I'm recording this video the afternoon of Thursday, August 26th, which means that we are making yet another video that is interjecting into the timeline of all the pre-recorded videos I have done over the past few days, because we have ourselves a really interesting topic that involves three players who play pretty different styles, and who are all particularly good at playing hockey. Let's talk today about Elias Pettersson and the contract negotiations with the Vancouver Canucks. Now, I will say, if there's a contract signed between now and the time this video is going to be uploaded, which is going to be in about 24 minus 4, 20-ish hours, then I apologize. But this video is indeed a big one. It is comparing two of the bigger contract signings we had yesterday, from your perspective, it's today for me, to what Elias Pettersson could potentially get. So, let's take our sights over to Carolina. We'll talk about Andrei Svechnikov, and we'll also talk about Sean Couturier of the Philadelphia Flyers. Now, sticking over with the contract that was signed first yesterday, let's talk about Svechnikov here. Now, Andrei Svechnikov was indeed a second overall pick at the 2018 NHL entry draft, one of the top guys of that draft, and it was so good to the point that sometime earlier in the draft season, we had some magazines and scouting outlets debating as to whether or not Svechnikov could even go first overall over Rasmus Dahlin. The scouting report for him back then when he was playing for the Barrie Colts was that this guy was the next coming of Malkin. You know, you talk about a powerful Russian guy who can go out there, just do his thing, score goals at will, fantastic hands, fantastic presence on the ice. Evgeny Malkin, Svechnikov, that was kind of the profile that was being pushed around a few months before the draft. Lo and behold, Svechnikov goes second overall, he makes the NHL right away, and he is an absolute monster by the time he hits year two. Now, his year one wasn't bad. He had 20 goals, 37 points in 82 games played, certainly not bad for an 18-year-old, but the season after that, hey, he was a point per game, 61 points, 68 games played. This year, though, 42 points in 55 games, and 8 points in 11 games in the postseason. Andrei Svechnikov was re-signed to an 8-year, $7.75 million AAV contract with no trade protection until 2025, which is going to be a modified no-trade clause. So, Svechnikov was a guy who, today, he's 21 years old, he was supposed to be that elite number one borderline franchise kind of winger who is going to be able to get a point per game sooner rather than later, and he just got signed to 7.75. Might I remind you, he was the first guy in NHL history to do the lacrosse goal in a game, and in fact, he is the only player to do it twice. So he is kind of in that territory of just borderline stardom, if not already being a star. And this contract is one that a lot of people around the league looked at and said, wow, if he becomes what we think he could be, if he scores 90-plus points a year for, I don't know, 4 out of the 8 years of his next contract, this deal is going to be a steal, especially if you consider the salary cap going up in the next few seasons. Immediately after we had Andrei Svechnikov sign his contract, we had a lot of Vancouver Canucks fans going out there and asking the question, okay, because Svechnikov got this amount of money and he's seen towards being an elite franchise borderline caliber player, where does Elias Pettersson fall into that conversation? Because take a look at Elias Pettersson. I mean, he's a guy who was drafted just a year before Svechnikov. He has been a fantastic, elite, borderline franchise guy for the Vancouver Canucks. And we've been talking about the contract negotiations for him. Does Svechnikov set the market for a guy like Petey? And the answer is no. It doesn't. I don't know why a lot of people in Vancouver Canuckland are talking about this as if, oh, Svechnikov signed 7.75, Pettersson's got to get 7.75 too, give him 8.75, because if Svechnikov's there, Pettersson can be in the same range and we're going to be good. I don't know why people are trying to think about it like that. If I can try to guess, maybe it's because they think, okay, Svechnikov is supposed to be an elite franchise kind of guy with a 90-plus point ceiling in the NHL, and I guess Pettersson has the same kind of label too. Therefore, they're in the same boat, and therefore they could get similar money, right? Well, not so fast. Let's go over onto Thomas Drantz because he posted a tweet that kind of summarizes it pretty well. Does Andrei Svechnikov's steal of a contract impact the Vancouver Canucks' leverage with Elias Pettersson? Firstly, yeah, it's a steal of a contract, especially if Svechnikov fulfills his potential. But at the same time, Andrei Svechnikov has played 50 more games in his career than Petey, and he has fewer goals and assists. The career points per game goes as follows. Svechnikov with a .68, Petey with a .93. What do you think? Furthermore, Elias Pettersson is a center, and Svechnikov is a winger, which kind of goes out there and defeats the entire comparable argument right there, doesn't it? Elias Pettersson right now, and I didn't realize this before I went out there and I started looking at all the stats, has been a lot better than Svechnikov based off of the limited sample size they have had at the NHL so far. They've both played 3 seasons, and Elias Pettersson has compiled a boatload more points, goals, and assists than Svech. EP40 is at 65 goals and 88 assists in 165 games for 153 total points. Svechnikov, take a look at his total numbers right here. He's at 209 games played, 59 goals, 81 assists, 140 points, and a .68 points per game. Therefore, Petey kind of outclasses him in every statistical category, and he is also a center, which gives him a lot more bargaining power. Sure, the difference in age is separated by 2 years, only one draft season though, because Petey was a late 98 birthday, Svechnikov was an early 2000s birthday, but they're still in very similar boats if you want to take a look at projection based off of what has already been accomplished. Sure, sometime down the line in 2025, they might be in very similar conversations in terms of points and production and all that, but so far, Petey should not be leveraged by the Svechnikov contract. Now, the next contract we had signed yesterday was another big one too. Sean Couturier, guess what? He's the Selke winner from 2020, and he got himself an 8-year extension too. Guess what his AAV is on his new contract? It's 7.75, which is exactly the same amount of money AAV-wise that Andrei Svechnikov is going to be getting as well. Now, a lot of people were looking at Couturier and saying, okay, well, Elias Pettersson is a really good two-way force. People were comparing him to Datsyuk. He's a guy that might be able to win a Selke sometime down the line. Couturier has that. Couturier is also a really good point producer, too. There's your comparable right there, right? If Svechnikov got 7.75 with the ceiling he has, and Couturier got 7.75 with the abilities that he has, which are both somewhat similar to Petey, could Petey get something in that $7-8 million range? Well, no. The answer is still no, and the reason for that is because Couturier is 28 years old. He has taken so long to develop into this role, where I get it, he has been fantastic. I don't want to take away from him in that respect. Over his last 4 seasons, he has averaged a .913 points per game, had a pair of 30-goal seasons, been a Selke Trophy first runner-up in 2018, and the winner in 2020. Even having a banged-up season last year, he still had 18 goals and 41 points. He is fantastic, but he is 28 years old. He's a lot older than Pettersson. What Couturier is doing right here is signing a contract in the midst of his prime. Heading into the long-term future, the contract is going to expire when he's 36 years old. Like, if you sign an 8-year deal for Petey, you are just leaving that contract at the tail end of maybe the end of his prime. Like, Couturier is gonna be in this state where he is so good for 3, 4, 5 years max. Pettersson has so much more ahead of him, he has done all this stuff, he's going to be better, and he's only 22, so the comparable isn't there either. Sure, are both of these contracts steals based off of what they could accomplish in the short-term future? Absolutely! But Pettersson is a different animal when you try to look at the factors that go into evaluating what a player should be worth monetary-wise. So, for Elias Pettersson, a guy who has been matching Couturier's best point-per-game seasons in the past 4 years, his entire career, at a significantly younger age, and who is also going to go out there and be better, there isn't a comparable for the contract that has been established so far. There have been conversations talking about, okay, if Pettersson is willing to go 8x8, you sign that immediately. You don't even think about it, you sign the dotted line. Pettersson, if he goes for 8 years, he's gonna get something like 9.5 plus 10 million, maybe 10.5, 11 maybe, because that's just kind of the market for younger guys that are centers and who have the capabilities that Pettersson does and who have been so good as Pettersson has been in their early starts to their careers. Matthews and the McDavids and the Draisaitls, I guess, but Draisaitl hadn't really proven himself at the time that he signed his contract back then compared to what he has done now, where he's like an Art Ross winner, Hart guy, etc. So, Petey, contract negotiations at the time of recording this video, they're not done yet, but these new ones right here, Carolina, Svechnikov, Philadelphia, Couturier, they're fantastic deals in the short term, don't get me wrong. Svechnikov's could become a steal down the line. Couturier's probably going to be a little bit overpaid by the end of it, but hey, I still don't believe they're comparables for Petey. Talk to me in the comments, though, if you agree. Am I correct in my assessment? Do I have flaws in it? That's kind of what the comment section is there for. It's your free reign. Go out there, talk to me about these conversations here. I hope you enjoyed this video. So, Schwarzenegger 99. And bye.